And we're live.
Hi! Sorry I'm a few minutes late. The baby had needs and it takes precedent over Periscope or YouTube if you're watching it later on there. Anyway, hi. I'm just glad to be here with you for this moment. And it's been a week. I'm sure it's been a week in your life too, so let's chat for a minute, and then I got other stuff to do, and I know you do too. So let's get right to the goods, the chocolate. I can't deny that this is one of my favorites. I'll be getting a new bag of these at a later date. Come on, hand. This hand doesn't work so well. This is called Dark Chocolate with Quinoa. It's from Costco, and amazing. Get this in your life. Phenomenal chocolate. Oh my goodness. Something about the the cocoa and then the crinkly quinoa on your mouth is just fabulous. In the words of James Wolfe, spectacular, if you will, and delightful. So I'm just going to have a little taste of it again like last time.
And someone's asking what the drink is. They asked if it was Four Loko, which I don't know what that means.
Oh, this is, do you say it LaCroix or LaCroix? I don't know, I think it's LaCroix. This is the remixed ones. This one is blackberry cucumber. It's quite delicious. Way back to when I couldn't swallow at all, which was over 11 months, I started to relearn to eat food with sparkling water because that's actually thicker than regular water. And the thicker sparkling water helped to push food down. So anyway, I kind of got obsessed with sparkling water then, and it's continued to this day. So cheers to the other addiction besides coffee. It's sparkling waters, and LaCroix is no exception. Anyway, I want to just jump in far more than my weird love of treats and talk to you briefly about something going on with me this week that probably is on many of your hearts as well, but I'll just share with you my thoughts briefly. I hate that it's my thoughts, whatever. I'll put it out there to you. Several weeks ago, when a lot of the Syrian refugee stuff was coming into my world, and I just really became a tiny bit more educated on the reality of what so many are facing around the world. Of course, if you flip on the news at night, international news, you see just the struggle and pain and tragedies that are happening all around us. And I think I was able to compartmentalize that stuff because that's there and I'm here. And so it was able to be put somewhere else, if you know what I mean. And then Oregon happened. And what was that, a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago? And that's closer to home. And potentially that's the persecution of my faith. And that's a little more my world. I'm in California. I'm not that far from Oregon. And then most recently, a young mother in my own neighborhood whose children attend the same school as James, some of her four children, died last week. And it's awful. That hits pretty close to home to have someone in your own neighborhood tragically die long before they should. And it's all kind of left me reeling of, you can compartmentalize things, but then when they're right in your backyard, you can't anymore. And you kind of have to try to make sense of them. And I don't know that there are good solutions for making sense of tremendous tragedy and suffering all over the world or in your own backyard. And we know that John 16:33 is true, that in this world, you will have trouble. You will have trouble. But you can take heart, be of good cheer, some translations say, because I have overcome the world. And I've heard it said before that this world is not a safe place. And I can testify to that. I was 26 years old, suffered a massive brain bleed, nearly died, and I get it. This world isn't safe, but we can take heart. Psalm 34:18 comes to mind, that the Lord is close to the brokenhearted. And I think there's a lot of broken hearts in this world. By the events of the last week, the last month, thousands of years before and before and before that. And suffering is with us. And what will we do with it? I don't know. But I know there is such a need for hope in the midst of tremendous suffering and sadness. And I pray that the God of hope can give us all hope and courage and bravery in the deepest trials and sadnesses we all go through. I pray Romans 15:13 that may the Holy Spirit. I love the notion of hope to get through the worst things. And of course, we all need to eat a pound of chocolate and maybe have an extra cup of coffee for some caffeine to help us drown our sorrows in times of hardship. And I don't know, I pray that we could all just love each other well while we're on earth in this broken, sad state, and find hope that there is always just a choice to live and lean into the worst and saddest things that we deal with in this life. I don't know, any Q&As or anything people are saying I need to know or no?
Lots of hellos from all over.
Hi, it's such a blessing. I didn't talk about it, I don't think, anywhere, but this weird little social media connection to you on Periscope is really this unique platform. A lot of people we don't know have watched, will watch from around the world. And I think they click on Los Angeles and then like pop into people's chats and see what they're saying. So anyway, if you're one of those people, I hope and pray that you're seeing some good stuff here, because this Catherine Wolf is kind of a messed up little package of joy happening, who wasn't supposed to even be here to sit at this table. And instead, I get to tell you about my love and my hope in Jesus. And that may really freak you out if you're watching this and you have no faith and are pretty against it. But it's undeniable that I was supposed to die. I didn't, and I've gotten better and better and better. And a lot of that, in my opinion, has to do with my faith. A lot. Now, I'm not talking about some weird healing thing. I'm purely talking about the hope deep in my soul to get out of bed in the morning. And that is fueled by that one. And I would like for you to engage in weekly with me and just see what you think, because something cool is happening here and may be worth looking into in your own life. Anything else I should know about or say? Or I love all you people. I'm so blessed that you're tuning in.
We have friends like Camilla Irvin, Iva Wolf.
Hey, Iva. Hey,
Marion Seindorf.
Hey, Miss Marion. Love you.
Natalie Pittman.
Who? Natalie Pittman? Yeah. Love you, Natalie. And love all you who I don't know who are out there. Being sweet. Supporting me in this weird, very vulnerable new media. I hope nobody writes anything mean on there, because I do get my feelings hurt really easily.
We just block them if they do.
That's true.
And Melissa Fisher's on here, or was on there too.
Oh, hey, Melissa. Okay. Hi, baby. Anyway, I will, I'll sign off now. I want to keep this short for you, but I pray you are encouraged by Chocolate Cat Chat, And I'm going to go eat some more chocolate and see you again next week. Talk to you then. Bye.